Today we will discuss about a sampling distribution. So in this, initially we require some basic information about the terms such as a population and sample. So population is nothing but collection of some objects, collection of objects. So it may be finite or infinite. The number of observations are nothing but population size. The number of observations in a population is nothing but population size. So in general we will represent population size with capital N. Next, sample. So sample means a subset of population. Okay, the number of items or observations in a sample is nothing but the sample size. So here a sample size is of two types, that is small samples and large samples. Suppose the number of items are less than 30 items, we can call that a sample as a small sample. If the number of items are greater than or equal to 30, we can call that sample as large samples. So in general we will represent the sample size with the small n. Okay, so here ma'am, along with this we must know about parameters and statistics. So parameters is nothing but the statistical measures which are calculated from the population, and statistics is nothing but the statistical measures which are computed from the sample, such as a sample mean, okay, x bar. So the example for the parameters are a population mean mu and population variance sigma square. Okay, so sampling distribution. So sampling distribution means the probability distribution of the statistic is nothing but sampling distribution. So here we will discuss about a sampling distribution of mean. When sigma known, so we can do the sampling with replacement and without replacement. So sampling with replacement, suppose if you are doing the sampling with replacement, the total number of samples equal to n power n. So here capital N represents the population size, small n represents the sample size. Okay, next, mean of the sampling distribution of means is given by mu x bar, which is equivalent to population mean. So here population mean mu can be estimated by using the formula mu equal to sigma x by n. Variance of the sampling distribution of means, it is given by sigma square x bar, which is equivalent to sigma square by n. Here sigma square is nothing but population variance, which can be calculated by using the formula sigma square equal to 1 by n minus 1 into sigma x minus x bar whole square. So from this variance of sampling distribution, we can estimate standard deviation of the sampling. Standard deviation of the sampling distribution of means is given by sigma x bar equal to sigma by root n. And here the standardized sample mean is given by z equal to x bar minus mu by sigma by root n. So here x bar is the sample mean, mu is the population mean by sigma by root n. So here sigma represents the population standard deviation, and here n represents the sample size. So we can do sampling without replacement. So when we do sampling without replacement, the total number of samples can be estimated by using the formula NCN. Okay, next, mean of the sampling distribution of means is given by mu x bar equal to mu, And variance of the sampling distribution of means is given by sigma square x bar, which is equal to sigma square by n into capital N minus small n by capital N minus 1. And the standard deviation of the sampling distribution of means is given by sigma x bar, which is equal to sigma by root n into square root of capital N minus small n by capital N minus 1, where capital N minus n by capital N minus 1 is the finite population correction factor. Let us see one example problem on sampling distribution of means. A population consists of 5 numbers, 2, 3, 6, 8 and 11. So consider all possible samples of size 2 which can be drawn with replacement and without replacement from this population. So find the mean of the population, the standard deviation of the population, the mean of the sampling distribution of means, the standard deviation of the sampling distribution of means. So here they asked to find the population mean, population standard deviation and the sampling distribution of means, mean of the sampling distribution of means, that is mu x bar, and standard deviation of the sampling distribution of means under a two various categories, that is sampling with replacement and sampling without replacement. Okay, so let us see the solution. So initially they asked to find the mean of the population. So we know that mean of the population is expressed as mu equal to sigma x by n in general. So mu is the population mean, so which is equal to total of population elements or population observations by number of population observations. So which is equal to here 2 plus 3 plus 6 plus 8 plus 11 by 5. So which is equal to 6. So next, variance of the population. So variance of the population is given by sigma square equal to 1 by n into sigma xi minus x bar whole square. So which is equal to 1 by 5, here population size is 5, so 1 by 5 into, so x values are nothing but the population items, that is a 2, 3, 6, 8, 11, and the x bar is nothing but the population mean, that is 6. So which is nothing but 1 by 5 into 2 minus 6 whole square plus 3 minus 6 whole square plus 6 minus 6 whole square plus 8 minus 6 whole square plus 11 minus 6 whole square. So on simplifying this, we get sigma square equal to 10.8. Okay, so from this we can calculate the standard deviation of the population, that is sigma. Sigma equal to square root of 10.8, so which is nothing but 3.29. So next they ask it to find out the mean of the sampling distribution of means and the standard deviation of the sampling distribution of means with replacement and without replacement. So let us see sampling with replacement. So here the total number of samples with replacement of size 2 is n power n, that is capital N power n, which is nothing but 5 square, that is 25. That is the total number of possible samples of size 2 is 25 here. And the possible samples are 2, 2, 3, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 11. Next 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 6, 3, 8, 3, 11. Next 6, 2, 6,3, 6, 6, 6, 8, 6, 11. And 8, 2, 8,3, 8, 6, 8, 8, 8, 11. Next 11, 2, 11,3, 11, 6, 11, 8, 11, 11. That is here we will consider the repetition. So and the possible and the sample means of all these possible samples are 2 plus 2 by 2, which means 4 by 2, that is 2. Similarly 2 plus 3 by 2, that is 2.5. So likewise if we calculate the means of these samples, we get 2, 2.5, 4, 4, 5, 6.5, 2.5, 3, 4.5, 5.5, 7, 4, 4.5, 6, 7, 8.5, next to 5, 5.5, 7, 8.5, 9.5, 6.5, 7, 8.5, 9.5, 11. And for this sample means, now we have to estimate the mean of the sampling distribution of means and standard deviation. So let us calculate the mean of the sampling distribution of means. So it is given by mu x bar, so which is nothing but a mean of these sample means. So which is nothing but, since we have 25 samples, it is 1 by 25 into 1 plus 2 plus 4 and so on up to 11. Okay, so if we calculate it more, we get a 6. And here if we see, this value must coincide with the population mean, that is mu equal to 6. Okay, so next we require to find the standard deviation of the sampling distribution of means. To estimate standard deviation, initially we will find the variance of the sampling distribution of means, and it is given by sigma square x bar equal to 1 by 25, total number of samples are 25, so 1 by 25 into x minus x bar whole square. So here x values means we will consider the sample means, that is a 2 minus 6, okay, 2 minus 6 whole square plus 2.5 minus 6 whole square plus and so on up to 11 minus 6 whole square. So on calculating this, we get a 5.40. okay, so next from this variance we will calculate the standard deviation of the sampling distribution of mean, that is a sigma x bar. So sigma x bar equal to square root of 5.40, so which gives a 2.32. So now we can cross verify whether we have got the right value or not through this verification. That is, we know that sigma x bar, that is a standard deviation of the sampling distribution of a mean value, coincide with the standard deviation of the population by root n. So we will check it, that is a population standard deviation is a 3.29, so 3.29 divided by 2, so which gives 2.32. suppose if we see this value coincide with this, okay, so simply we can say that we have done it correctly. Okay,
population data is 2, 3, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 11, next 3, 6, 3, 8, 3, 11, 6, 8, 6, 11, and 8, 11. And the means of these samples, okay, so for these samples means are 2 plus 3 by 2, that is 2.5. similarly 2 plus 6 by 2, that is 4. So likewise, if we find out the means of these samples, we get 5, 6.5, 4.5, 5.5, 7, 7, 8.5, and 9.5. So next we will find out that the standard deviation of mean of the sampling distribution of the means and standard deviation of the sampling distribution of means. So let us see the mean of the sampling distribution of means, and it is given by mu x bar. So mu x bar equal to 1 by n into sum of these samples, so which is nothing but 1 by 10 into 2.5 plus 4 plus and so on plus 9.5. So we on simplifying this, we get a 6. And if you see, this value will coincide with the population mean mu. Okay, so next we will find out the variance first in order to calculate standard deviation of the sampling distribution of means. sigma square x bar equal to 1 by n into sigma x minus x bar whole square. So which is nothing but here n equal to 10, since we have 10 possible samples. So 1 by 10 into 2.5 minus 6 whole square plus 4 minus 6 whole square plus and so on, 9.5 minus 6 whole square. On simplifying now we get a x value as a 4.05. So then from this we can estimate the standard deviation of the sampling distribution of means, that is the sigma x bar, which is equal to square root of 4.05. So which is nothing but 2.01. So let us verify. Okay. So we know that one, this is standard deviation of the sampling distribution of means is can be calculated by using the formula sigma x bar equal to sigma by root 10 into square root of n minus n by n minus 1. So in order to verify, so let us find the value of sigma by root n into square root of capital N minus n by capital N minus 1. So which is nothing but a 3.29 population standard deviation, 3.29 by root 2 into square root of 5 minus 2 by 5 minus 1. On simplifying now we get its value as 2.01. So which is nothing but the value of sigma x bar. Okay.
So let us see one more problem. So the mean height of students in a college is 155 centimeters and standard deviation is 15. So what is the probability that the mean height of 36 students is less than 157 centimeters? So here ma, they ask to find the probability that the mean height of 36 students is less than 157 centimeters. That is, they ask to find probability of x bar less than or equal to 157 centimeters. So in order to estimate that, here they have given that the population mean, that is the overall height, mean height of the students is 155 centimeters, that is the mu is given as 155 and the standard deviation is given as 15, that is population standard deviation sigma equal to 15. And here they have collected 16 students among the students in the college, that is a here sample size n equal to 36, and here they ask you to find out probability of x bar less than or equal to 157. So in order to find out that, here we can use the standardized normal mean, that is z equal to x bar minus mu by sigma by root n. So now we will estimate this normal variate z at the sample mean x bar equal to 156. So at x bar equal to 156, z equal to x bar minus mu by sigma by root n. So which is equivalent to 156, that is x bar is 156 minus mu is here 155 by sigma is 15 by square root of n, that is a root 36. So on simplifying we get 0.8. So therefore we can easily estimate the probability of x bar less than or equal to 157. So which means probability of z less than or equal to 0.8. So in order to find the value of this, here we have to go for normal tables. So at z equal to 0.8, okay, we get the value of it as 0.7881. That is the probability that the mean height of 36 students is less than 157 centimeters is 0.7881.